Gentlemen, thank you for coming. It is a gorgeous day. I will take a brief moment to ask that everybody triple, double checks their cell phones, make sure they are on silent, and put away for the remainder of the ceremony. Just enjoy these two lovebirds finally getting married. We are about to begin. Marriage is perhaps the greatest and most challenging adventure of a lifetime. A commitment in life that allows two people to find and bring out the best in each other. It offers opportunities for sharing and growth that no other relationship can equal. A good marriage must be built on the foundation of this commitment. In marriage, the little things are the big things. It's never being too old to hold hands middle of the forest. It's remembering to say, I love you, at least once a day. It is never going to sleep angry. It's standing together and facing the world. It is speaking words of appreciation and demonstrating gratitude in thoughtful ways. It is having the capacity not only to forgive, but to forget. It's giving each other an atmosphere in which each can grow. It's a common search for the good and for the beautiful. It is not only marrying the right partner, it is being the right partner. You're gathered here today in the presence of friends, family, birds, squirrels, and the Lord above to join Rebecca Bryan and Andrew Proctor in matrimony. We are going to be participating in a hand-fasting ceremony today. I will ask that Ego Damon and Tyler come up and bring their ribbons. I will have you slightly... Yep. your feet too much. And join your right hands at the wrist. No, they're left. Fire in the forest. Deceiving. I will ask you to take your right hand, wrist to wrist. And why don't you three come up, place the ribbons over their hands, evenly distributed, to represent the binding ties that are your families, and the strongest tie of all, who is the Lord above. Before I tie your knot that binds both of you together, I do have something I would like to read. These are the hands of your best friend, young and strong and full of love for you, that are holding yours on your wedding day, as you promise to love each other today, tomorrow, and forever. These are the hands that will work alongside yours as you build your futures together. These are the hands that will passionately love you and cherish you throughout the years, with the slightest of touch, comfort you like no other. These are the hands that will hold you when fear or grief fill your mind. These are the hands that will countless times wipe the tears from your eyes, tears both of sorrow and of joy. These are the hands that will tenderly hold your children, the hands that will join your family as one. These are the hands that will give you strength when you need it, support and encouragement to pursue your dreams, and to comfort you in difficult times. And lastly, these are the hands that even when wrinkled in age, will still be reaching for yours, giving you that same unspoken tenderness that just comes to you. We will be tying an infinity knot. I understand that you two would like to read your own vows to each other. Now, with the ties binded, you will recite your vows. Your hands are a little busy. This is a challenge.
You know, I love telling the story of how we met. I won't do that right now because everybody here has heard of the pitching hand ties. I remember like it was yesterday, like my setting eyes at the first thing, staring back at me. But in that moment, I knew there was something very special about you. I was definitely right. And just as time stood still that moment, our eyes first locked. We have this moment right now. And it feels like the world is stopping. You're giving us a chance. And like the first day we met when I was awestruck by you, I'm standing here now knowing this feeling is eternal. Moreover, forever with you looks wonderful. I promise I will always cherish, honor, and display you. I promise my love will stay strong and true as I keep spiders my power away from you. I promise I will support you in any way I can, your feelings, your opinions, and the need to be touched in. And I promise to love you always and forever.
I'm back to
do that. I wrote it in there.
Spoken your vows to each other, and with that we will bind the ties. If you will take your left hand around these, a little bit closer to the knot, do the same. As you separate, I will read Ecclesiastes. A person standing alone can be attacked, defeated, but two can stand back to back and conquer. Three is even better. And the triple braided cord is not easily broken. And if you would like to drape it over the shoulder, around the shoulder. To commemorate this union, Becca and Andy will now exchange rings. The circle formed by each ring symbolizes your eternal love and commitment to each other. Let these rings remind you always of the love and promises that you have made here today. State of Pennsylvania, and the Lord above, I now pronounce you husband and wife. You may kiss the bride.
It is my great honor and privilege to be the first to announce Mr. and Mrs. Proctor. Why don't you two take a walk down the aisle together real quick? Thank you.